So we're here at WWDC checking out all the new updates that Apple just announced on stage for iOS and macOS. Now, one of the big things that it announced for iOS is called ARKit 2. Now, that's an updated framework of its augmented reality tool set for developers. It basically lets developers make even more advanced augmented reality apps using the smartphone's cameras and its sensors. Now, one of the new updates that's coming with ARKit 2 is called multiplayer AR games. Now, essentially, you make an app, an ARKit app, and you're allowed to bring everybody into one shared world. That means multiple people with multiple devices are all seeing the same thing that's fixed in space, but it's made out of code and it doesn't really exist. Now, one of the games Apple developed just to show this off is called slingshot. It's a multiplayer game, a multiplayer slingshot game, and it supports up to 4 players at the same time. Now, what we did was me and Dieter were on the same team. We were facing 2 other attendees here at WWDC. We each had an iPad Pro, a 9.7-inch iPad Pro, and we had a whole table full of obstacles that we had to knock down using a slingshot. The goal of the game was to knock down your opponent's 3 flags, and if your slingshot got knocked down, you had to move to another one and use that one instead. Now, for a game that I've never played before, we were pretty good at it, actually, and we won both of our games back-to-back.
Where's the last one?
Oh, what's up?
Now, that said, it is still quite difficult. You really have to move around, you have to get angles, you have to basically get lower, higher, you have to really use the physical space to take advantage of the full breadth of the augmented reality features. Now, we saw something similar at Google I.O., where Google introduced cross-platform augmented reality multiplayer games. But on iOS, and especially with ARKit's sophistication, you can expect to see a little bit more polished experiences, and slingshot was definitely one of those. Now, it's just the first of what could be many, many, many multiplayer AR apps that developers can make for the iOS platform. We won't see any of those, unfortunately, until September when iOS 12 launches. ARKit 2.0 is part of that new iOS update, and it's not coming to the public until presumably the new iPhones in September come out. That said, developers are going to be able to get their hands on this software very soon, and they're going to be able to start building experiences that work in beta starting basically this week. So the WWDC keynote is wrapped, and now we're on the hunt for more cool things to get on video. If you want to read all of the Apple news and everything it announced here at WWDC, check out theverge.com. See ya.